This video is brought to you by Miro. One of my most successful and loved videos on this channel is the macOS beginner's guide I published last year, which is just as relevant today. After so many views and amazing feedback, I think it only makes sense to follow that up with a guide for those of you who are now familiar with macOS, you know, feeling comfortable using it on a daily basis. Think of this video as part 2, a guide for intermediate, where I'll show you tips and features I personally use all the time that will make you extremely efficient when using your Mac. None of them are complicated, yet all of them are super useful. At the end, I'll go to some power shortcuts as well. Let's warm up with a very simple one. Zooming in system-wide. This is something that I honestly can't live without, and it's one of the first things I do with a new Mac. Open System Settings and go to Accessibility. Under Vision, go to Zoom and enable Use Scroll Gesture with Modifier Key and select the Control button, for example. Once this is enabled, no matter where I am, I can simply hold Control and scroll in and out to where my mouse pointer is. Having this ability at my fingertips eliminates the need to even think about zooming in on, let's say, the browser, and in many cases, even on documents. It's a feature that literally saves my eyes from suffering when trying to read a fine print or look at something small. In fact, I take this feature so seriously that a lot of times I use it to just space out from the UI and the elements around the apps that I use and just focus at the task at hand. For example, writing. The next very simple feature that I can't live without daily is taking screenshots. This is built in and enabled by default, and it can be executed in a few ways. In its simplest form, you can press Command plus Shift plus 3 and you'll take a screenshot of the entire screen in front of you. Exactly like taking a screenshot on your iPhone by pressing volume up and the power button at the same time. The screenshot stays floating on the screen for a few seconds before it ends up either on your desktop by default or the downloads folder or a place where you decide to change it to go to. The destination can be changed by opening the built-in screenshot app. Another way to take a screenshot, and this is the most used way for me, is to press Command plus Shift plus 4, and the mouse cursor turns into a crosshair icon which you can move around and drag to grab a screenshot of just a simple element. Note that when you start dragging, you can see the dimensions of the screenshot in pixels. Here's how I use it all the time. Let's say I need a logo for a project of mine. I simply snap it on the fly and drag it directly while floating into my photo editing app. There, I remove the background in a flash and export with transparent background just like that. Okay, so let's say I want to showcase my website in a presentation. I'm gonna use screenshots for that, so let me show you. I press Command Shift 4 as before, but before I do anything, I hit space, and now I'm presented with this icon here, which I can use to take a screenshot of the actual window. So I just snap it, and I grab it from the floating corner, bring it back to my presentation, and voila. Next up, forget about Command plus V. Many times when you paste text from somewhere else, you end up pasting the formatting as well. I can't tell you how many times I witness people wasting their time removing the formatting of whatever they copied. Most often this happens while compiling an email and pasting information from the outside, only to end up with an email that looks unprofessional. Instead, learn to paste with Command plus Option plus Shift plus V. Pasting like this removes the formatting, placing the text as plain text. Okay, so instead of writing your address every time you fill out a form or you're making a payment, which usually takes a while, let me show you something very clever. Open your system settings and go to Keyboard and go to Text Replacements. Now, hit the plus sign and type in, for example, exclamation mark ADD from address, and just paste the full address as you normally paste it in the forms. That's it. Now, when you fill out a form, instead of typing this entire address, just type in exclamation mark add and hit space. And now we have the address filled out in a matter of seconds. How cool is that? Whether I'm preparing a guide like this or a compilation video like my latest iPhone accessories episode, I spend quite a lot of time organizing ideas and products. Since I'm a visual person, I find it way easier to compile my thoughts in a way that allows me to see how everything fits together. For that, I use Miro, which is a visual platform to connect, collaborate, and create. Miro is available on pretty much all devices, and I've recently started using it for my more complicated projects as it allows me to create a combination of charts, maps, and other frameworks organized in different boards, which I can later share with my associate when it's time to shoot. Miro brings teams together no matter the location, office, remote, or hybrid. You can keep the ideas flowing by creating, building, and sharing with the help of sticky notes, images, mind maps, and more in order to visualize projects and ideas of any scope. There are tons of different templates that you can use to start your visual journey while also taking advantage of the built-in AI assistant to, let's say, create mind maps from scratch. So join the 50 plus million users and check out Miro in the first link in the description below. Let's talk hot corners. Each of the corners of your Mac screen can be used as a hot corner, a place where you can drag your mouse to and trigger an action. This is something that I showcase in my step-by-step guide on how I set up a new Mac video, which I'll link at the end of this episode. So my hot corners are set as follows. If I bring my mouse to the top left, I open the Launchpad, the place where all my apps exist. Top right opens Mission Control, which I use a lot, especially when working on a dual monitor setup like this. The bottom left launches the screensaver, which aside from looks, is yet another way I can quickly lock the Mac if I want to step away for a moment. Assuming, of course, you have activated the lock option on the screensaver. Finally, the bottom right triggers the application windows, which is handy if I have few windows of the same app opened, allowing me to find the active window I want to move next to. Next, let's talk about renaming files. Instead of tapping on the name of the file and waiting a second only to tap again to rename it, or even right-click to select the option to rename it, simply select the file and hit return, and you'll be ready to change its name. In most cases, macOS cleverly leaves the file extension out of the selection, so you can quickly rename it without worrying you'll mess up, you know, the file type. If you want to take it up a notch, you can batch rename files by selecting them and right-click to choose rename. This way, you can replace, add, or format the text of the file selected.
So I have this folder which is filled with 55 photos that I want to batch rename. To do that, all I have to do is select all the files and right-click to go to rename. Now from here, I'm gonna go to format. And I'll say that all the file names will start with the label photo. And I'll hit space to have a little space between the photo and the number. So all the files will be labeled photo and then they will start with number 1. And I'll hit rename. And boom, all of them are renamed. Now, if you want, you can right click again, rename. And then if you want to have the number before that for some sort of organization, you can do the number should be before the name. So number, and then I'll put the space instead of at the end of the label photo before the photo, so that there is a nice, you know, space between the digit and the actual name. And I'll hit rename. And it's as easy as that.
Okay, so one of the reasons I love the Apple Watch is the tight integration with the Mac. The most use case of the marriage between those two devices is unlocking the Mac automatically with the watch. To enable this, go to System Settings, touch ID and Password, and enable the watch you want to use to unlock the Mac, which should be using the same Apple ID as your Mac. The next time you power up the Mac, you'll feel a gentle tap on the wrist right away, and you'll save yourself from having to type that super long password. Next, at this point, I assume you know how to use Command plus Tab to move around your active apps. But did you know that you can Command Q while Command Tabbing for quickly quitting an app, you know, right there on the spot? This comes in handy when you complete a work sprint and you want to quickly clean up your space and close the tools that you won't be needing anymore.
Okay, so whenever you search something on the Mac by default, if you go to the search bar and you type in the file name that you're looking for, you start looking for information that is on the Mac. And I think this is redundant because I can just as easily use Spotlight to just do a global search on the Mac. Instead, if I'm looking for something here, I'm most likely looking for a file which is within that folder that I'm right now. What I normally do with each new Mac, and I talk about this in my How I Set Up a New Mac video, I go to the Finder settings, and then I'll go to Advanced, and I change this last option. When performing a search, instead of searching this Mac, I search the current folder, which I think makes more sense. So when I go to Finder again and I search for it, it's going to be looking for whatever is located in that folder.
Let's say you want to create a listing for something you're selling online and the platform you're uploading your images to has an image size limit. In that case, instead of looking for an image optimizer tool or, you know, resizing images individually, you can do the following. In Finder, grab the images you want to convert, right-click to open the Quick Actions menu, and choose Convert Image. Aside from changing the format of the images, for example, PNG to JPEG, you can choose a smaller size format, where macOS even gives you an estimate of how big the new images would be upon converting. This will not replace your originals, but instead create copies, and know that macOS is extremely good at this, as even in their smallest format, they will look very sharp and crispy. Now let me show you some shortcuts that I use almost all the time, starting with probably the most unpopular one, which I'm sure you'll utilize right away. Command plus L. This shortcut selects the full URL of a website you're currently interacting with. This is super clutch when you want to quickly copy that URL to paste somewhere else, or you just want to move to the next website. And yes, it works in other browsers as well. Option plus Command plus H is your Zen shortcut. It hides all open windows and leaves you only with the current active app in front of you, which is one of the fastest ways to eliminate distractions. Control plus Command plus Space pulls up emojis. Shift plus Command plus 5 pulls up the screen recording menu which I mentioned earlier, which can be used for recording or just doing screenshots. From there, you can also change the screenshot folder destination and more. Command plus left or right bracket allows you to go backwards and forwards in Finder. If you're in the process of organizing a batch of files, this might come in handy. Control, Command, and Q immediately locks the screen. Command plus comma opens the settings window of the app that is currently in use. The Option key on the Mac, by the way, hides a plethora of hidden features that you can take advantage of, like tapping on the clock of the Apple menu to quickly toggle Do Not Disturb mode. If you want to learn more hidden options, check out this video here. If you're stepping into the Mac world for the first time, check out the Mac Beginner's Guide here. Like and subscribe to the channel as well as my newsletter. And as always, it's been an absolute pleasure. This is Z, over and out.